On the way out, he did kiss me.
Hey, what up, everybody? Jason Lee. So we just put out the story about Tristan Thompson, Khloe Kardashian's baby daddy, cheating or messing around with Kylie Jenner, Khloe Kardashian's sister's best friend, Jordan Woods. Apparently, there's a lot of speculation. Everybody's going back and forth saying, why would Jordan do that? That's not true. It is true. You know why? Because one of my writers was there. And Tristan, you took everybody's phone, but you let them stay. Jordan came in. Y'all was smoking hookah. She was all up in your lap. You was all over her. Touchy-feely. And you let the girl spend the night till 7 in the morning. Now, that happened. That's a fact. And I don't want to hear nobody trolling Khloe talking about you. It's a Kardashian curse. It's Khloe's fault. This and no. If a nigga ain't shit, he ain't shit. And Tristan, the fact that you slept with her sister's or messed around with her sister's best friend, we don't know if you slept together. And the fact that Kylie, your best friend, was at the house doing all that, get her out now and get him out too. What up, everybody? Jason Lee. So we just put out the story about Tristan Thompson, Khloe Kardashian's baby daddy, cheating or messing around with Kylie Jenner, Khloe Kardashian's sister's best friend, Jordan Woods.
This has been difficult for three families and it's been rough.
I've known Jordan Woods her whole life. Many don't know this, but her father, John Woods, was a sound engineer on The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air for its entire run, where he and Will became friends. Their sons, Josh Woods and Trey, became very close, and through many play dates between them, Jaden and Jordan ended up becoming true day ones by forging a close lifelong bond since they were infants. These friendships made the Woods family an extension of ours. During middle school, Jaden became a bridge of friendship between Jordan and Kylie Jenner, and the two became inseparable. The friendships between Jaden, Jordan, and Kylie brought three families together where many bonds were made. In February, guests at a house party reported that Jordan and NBA star Tristan Thompson, the father of Khloe Kardashian's daughter, were making out and that Jordan spent the night with him. The immediate online and media backlash that followed has forced three families, the Woods, Kardashian and Jenners, and the Smiths, into a painful and very public incident. So when Jordan reached out to me and asked me if I would help her story to be heard, I invited her to the red table to figure out how to deal, heal, and move forward.
Well, I didn't think I'd be coming to the table like this, but it's the best place to be.
Hey, listen, that table has mythological cleansing and healing power.
I believe that.
I would have loved to be there. There's a lot of things about our relationship to her family. Jordy's father worked on Fresh Prince before she was born, and I know how hard it was for you and your family when he passed. And I was watching you grow and become a woman, and I had a deep sense that we would be here one day. And what I want to say to you is that the world attacks. It just happens. You'll never get around the world attacking. But I want you to know that you are supported, and I got you, and we got you.
Yeah, and that means the world to me.
Yeah.
You've known me before I knew myself.
Yeah.
Babe,
do you have any fatherly advice?
I would say take your medicine and tell your truth. This is a part of a huge lesson.
Yeah.
It's like, this world is not going to break you. We won't allow it.
Yeah. I want to give you the opportunity to tell your truth, but I want you to tell it through the lens of what your part has been, because that's the only part you can change.
Sunday night, I went to dinner with some friends, and I went to this bar after there was a party going on. I was minding my business, dancing, drinking. Tristan was there. He was doing his own thing. That was it. After the club, normal LA culture, when you're young, go to the bar, go to the club, it ends early. We all go to a house after.
Right.
We're not thinking about whose house or where it's at. We're just, you know, we're all having fun. We're in the moment. The group of girls that I'm with are like, you know, we're going to go to a house. On the way out, they're saying it's Tristan's house. I'm like, cool. That's okay. Feels like a safe environment. I'd rather it be his house than a random stranger.
Right.
He didn't even personally invite me there. Right. It wasn't like, come see me. It was like, oh, I'm hopping in the car. I'm coming with y'all. Y'all are going here. Cool. I know him even better.
Right.
We pull up. We walk in. Not once was I aware of anyone's phone or told them to take away a phone. I was not paying. I don't care. I don't have anything to hide.
Right.
So when it comes to the phones being taken away, I have no clue who told them to take away the phone, anything.
Right.
All I know is I had my own.
Right.
And, you know, we're all dancing and we're all drinking and we're all enjoying the time. And I'm not thinking I shouldn't be here.
Right.
And that's my first step where I went wrong. And how I would feel if someone close to me is hanging at my ex's house or the father of my child. I didn't think about that. That's the first part of the problem.
So you're saying, you're saying I shouldn't have been there in the first place.
Yeah, that's the first step is I should have gone home after.
What from the night would suggest that there was a lap dance of some kind?
Now, this seems completely crazy to me that anybody says there was a lap dance involved, because there was no lap dance involved. But what I can think as to why someone would say that, there was a chair here, a couch, and another chair.
Got it.
It's all filled.
Got it.
So he's sitting in this chair, and there's an arm of the chair that goes up about here.
Okay.
And I'm sitting on the arm of the chair. So you come into the party and you look and you see me sitting on the chair. In my head, this is innocent. You know, like, we're all drinking, we're all chilling. There's no way it would look like a lap dance, but I could see why people would say, oh, they're getting cozy.
Mm-hmm. Did you have your arm around him?
No.
Okay.
But my legs were laying right over his.
Got it.
Okay. My butt was never sitting on him.
But your legs were, so he
But my legs were dangling down, so I picked them up and I put them over.
To onto his legs?
Onto the bottom of his legs, yes.
Onto the bottom of his legs.
There's stories that she was sitting on his lap. She was dangling in his crotch area. That is not the truth. I finally look outside and I'm like, look, the sun's coming up. I need to take myself home.
Right.
And, you know, I tell everyone I'm leaving. I tell Tristan I'm leaving. And he's like, are you sure? You know, it's fine. You can be safe here. And I'm like, you know what? I need to go. My car's outside. I had a driver outside. It's been waiting. So this is where the story gets tricky. I was drunk.
Okay.
I was not tipsy. I was drunk.
Right.
But I was not beyond the point of recollection. I know where I was. But on the way out, he did kiss me.
No, and what do you mean by kiss?
It's just no passion, no nothing on the way out. He just kissed me and
like a tongue kiss, like a peck on the lips,
No, it was like a kiss on the lips, but no tongue kiss, no making out.
Got it.
Nothing. And I don't think that he's wrong either, because I allowed myself to be in that position. And when alcohol's involved, people make you know, dumb moves, or people get caught up in the moment, or who knows?